the skies will be good to us, Zach.
Yeah, I don't know. We're going to have more cloud cover moving in after midnight tonight. Your chances will probably be the following weekend for that. For Halley's Comet, I can't go out that far. 2061 is when that one's coming around, and that's at the limit of my forecasting ability. Let's check out what we've got outside right now. And what I can tell you right now is it is gorgeous, and it will still be gorgeous a couple hours from now. 80 degrees, say northwest wind at 17, gusting to 23, so it's breezy. It's also very dry with relative humidity of just 23%. And looking at other temperatures across Virginia, it doesn't matter where you go. All across the Commonwealth, it is absolutely beautiful. Mid to upper 70s, even a few 80s out there, including the Richmond area. And it's, again, it's even comfortable in the warmer weather as well because of the low humidity. It'll be much cooler tomorrow. And when I say much cooler, I'm talking 25 degrees cooler than it is right now at this time tomorrow. A huge difference with some light rain developing as well. And then the cool weather's going to stick with us all week long and even into the weekend. Not necessarily a bad thing this weekend because we'll have some sunshine around making Mother's Day really comfortable. It looks like temperatures will make it in the low and mid 60s with some sunshine, but there is a chance for a killing frost as well in parts of Virginia this weekend. A late season frost at that. All right, nothing but sunshine out here right now. Back to our west is the next storm system, and it is heading in our direction, gaining a little steam as well. You can see a couple watch boxes in Oklahoma. The overall pattern is a trough digging into the central United States, and this dip in the jet stream will translate eastward, and then it's going to get reinforcing shots. So while the overall shape may change some, it is going to be troughing with us all week long. That translates to much cooler weather than normal. Look at what's going on out here right now. We have upper 40s and low 50s northern tier states, low 100s in Texas, 102 in Midland right now, and we're going to get the cooler end of all of this. In fact, our first 90 degree day would be very normal for it to occur now. It's nowhere anytime soon, at least a week. All right, lows tonight will be in the mid to upper 40s in most spots, with highs tomorrow making it only into the low and mid 50s. Absolutely nothing like today. Here's a look at your skycast. If you get out early in the morning, your chances are pretty good at not getting any rainfall, and really not until around noon or after is when we'll see the better chances of rain kicking in. Again, the big story is going to be not the rain, but the cool weather. Rest of tonight, clouds build in after midnight. And here come the showers. We'll have showers around. Looks like the best area would be across southern and western Virginia for rainfall tomorrow. And then as we get into Wednesday, we'll have more showers kind of lingering as this low pressure area kind of hangs with us and slows down a little bit. And then we'll get a break on Thursday before more rain will be possible coming up on Friday. So here's your temperature trend. High of just 55 tomorrow, 61 Wednesday, and look at this, it's just 60s all the way. This is looking more like March than May. Mother Nature's been in quarantine a little too long, the way it looks right now. And there are your first 90 degree days of the year over the past 10 years. So you see lots of Mays in there and some Aprils as well. The latest, at least in recent memory, that has occurred was June 11th back in 2016. The all-time latest was July 2nd. And so it's going to be at least another week before we get that heat in here. And then it'll be remain to be seen if we see it even after a week. There's a look at your 7-day forecast. Again, Mother's Day right now looking beautiful, but watch out for those frosts this weekend.